Democrats are trying to create a very big tent as they build a coalition aimed at sending Joe Biden to the White House. The party kicked off its national convention yesterday with a wide range of speakers, from Republican John Kasich to Senator Bernie Sanders and former First Lady Michelle Obama. Of course, due to the pandemic, the convention was scaled back and moved mostly online. Much of it is being pre-recorded. Before coronavirus, party leaders had planned a huge gathering in Wisconsin. It was one of the swing states that helped President Trump win in 2016. Ben Wikler is the chair of Wisconsin's Democratic Party, and he joins us now from Madison. Welcome, Ben. Great to have you with us. So, Wisconsin has a Democratic governor, but the state legislature has been controlled by Republicans for nearly a decade. What is being done there to ensure the integrity of the vote in November?
Thanks so much for having me on, Tanya, and greetings from America's Dairyland, the ultimate battleground state this cycle and the home of our virtual convention. The fight over the right to vote is now central to our politics here. Governor Evers, the Democratic Party of Wisconsin, in court and through organizing and grassroots and independent and just civic organizations, have been fighting to make it easier for people to request absentee ballots. And Republicans have been refusing to take any of those measures at every step. I'll give one example. To request an absentee ballot here, you have to go to myvote.wi.gov, upload a photo of your voter ID, your ballot comes in the mail, and then you need a witness signature on the ballot envelope to make it legal. Those restrictions make it tough for people in the midst of social distancing and this pandemic. So we actually had a federal court offer some relief on that, and Republicans sued all the way up to the United States Supreme Court and got a partisan decision that clawed some of that relief back. This will be a fight all the way through November 3rd.
And possibly beyond. I mean, I want to, though, ask you about Democrats' strategy there. It is safe to say that they made a mistake by ignoring Wisconsin in 2016. What's the plan to keep the party's attention on Wisconsin this year?
This year, I think every Democrat in America, certainly starting with Joe Biden and Kamala Harris, recognizes that Wisconsin is central. The Trump campaign itself said, if we win Wisconsin, we win the election. If we lose Wisconsin, we lose the election. And that has lit a fire under every Democrat and every Trump-opposing independent and, frankly, Trump-opposing Republican in our state. We have seen unprecedented levels of grassroots energy. And you could see that in the spring Supreme Court election in Wisconsin, where Trump heartily endorsed a Republican candidate for what's supposed to be a nonpartisan office. And Democrats turned out in droves in the midst of this pandemic and voter suppression. They smashed every record for absentee voting. And people waited in line for hours to cast votes in person because they didn't want their ballot to be taken away. We are still seeing that in our virtual organizing with virtual phone banks and text messages week in, week out. And frankly, the GOP is struggling to catch up with the level of grassroots organizing that we see in the Badger State, thanks in part to the constant investment by the DNC and the Biden campaign and grassroots supporters all over the country and all over Wisconsin.
And speaking of the GOP, so the Democrats made a big show of Ohio Republican John Kasich speaking at the convention last night. Can voices like his have an impact on some of those Wisconsin moderates or moderate Republicans who are still not sure they can vote for Biden but are not crazy about Trump anymore?
I think that everything actually makes a difference with a lot of those voters who are on the fence. For people that voted in 2016 for Donald Trump, and then maybe voted for Tony Evers or Tammy Baldwin or both in 2018, they're now in this place of trying to figure out where to go next. And I think that the way that Democrats win this cycle, especially in a state where three of the last five presidential elections has had an under 1 percentage point margin, is by making the case to everyone that this president had his moment to respond to a crisis affecting every person's life, the COVID pandemic, and he's failed to do it. So whether you like him or hate him on every other point, we need to get out of this mess to be able to safely reopen our economy and safely reopen schools, as well as to address the chronic crisis of racism that's playing out so brutally in the context of this pandemic. If we're going to address this pandemic, we need someone who actually knows how to do it. It's clear that Trump is not up to the job. And I welcome Republican voters, third-party voters for Libertarian and Green candidates, everybody. Let's all get on board and get a new president who knows what he's doing. because time is running out.
So what do you think is gained and lost by having a non-traditional convention like this? And does this to you seem like the future?
The biggest thing that's lost for us in Wisconsin was a moment to really have Milwaukee and Wisconsin shine on the national stage to bring hundreds of millions of dollars of business to especially small businesses in Milwaukee that could sorely use that kind of investment right now. The magic of just gathering in person in a state that has never hosted a national convention before. The thing that's gained is that by organizing this virtually, we can really tailor it. The convention team can really tailor it to the experience of the viewer in their home, in every corner of Wisconsin and in every corner of the country. It feels more personal. You watch it and there's no sense that you're missing out on something that people who are there are experiencing. And what I've been hearing from folks who've been watching it, including members of our Wisconsin DNC delegation, is just tremendous excitement about what they see. I think that we are learning lessons that will be applied to every future convention, whether they're in person or a hybrid or virtual. There's stuff that is happening now that's never been tried before, and it's working beautifully. One piece I just want to point to, every day in this convention, we're running huge virtual trainings. You can sign up at training.win for organizers to learn digital organizing techniques. Thousands are participating. That was impossible in a regular convention environment.
Well, it certainly sounds like the enthusiasm and the energy is not lost. You know, it's been about a week since we heard Biden select his running mate, Senator Kamala Harris. How are Wisconsin Democrats responding to the Biden-Harris ticket?
It is so much excitement. I can't overstate how delighted people have been. Kamala Harris has Wisconsin ties. She lived in Wisconsin when she was a child. We claim her as an honorary badger for life. She also campaigned here in 2018 and helped to fuel the blue wave that allowed us to sweep every statewide election for the first time since 1982. So I think Wisconsin knows Kamala, Kamala knows Wisconsin, and there's a real sense of making history, of smashing boundaries that should never have been there in the first place, and of having a clarion call, a voice that's so powerful in making the case that we need change. I'm really excited about the Kamala Harris-Mike Pence debate, and it's also just going to be really exciting to see her tomorrow night as she accepts the vice presidential nomination at our convention.
All right. Well, Ben Wikler, chair of Wisconsin's Democratic Party, thank you for sharing your enthusiasm with us. That's clear. There's a lot of enthusiasm there in Wisconsin. Thanks so much for joining us.
Thanks so much for having me on.